Al or at Lil Starnerd on Instagram, and welcome to today's episode of
Barbie Dreamhouse.
Before we get started, gentle little reminder that I have a Patreon, so if you guys want to support me in any way, I have a $1 tier, and it would be super appreciated, but no pressure. Today we are reviewing the Hini Jelly Gouache set, as requested by a lovely subscriber. I've been using these for some time. The company actually sent this to me and paid me for a post on Instagram a couple weeks, months ago, but this video is entirely separate. This has nothing to do with the company. This is just because someone asked for the video and because I like talking about paint. So let's talk about paint. So I have the 24 color set, and each little cup of paint is 30 milliliters. It comes in blue, a really pretty, like, light minty green color, yellowy orange, and then I have the pink one. This particular size is somewhere between $20 and $30 on Amazon, but the price is listed at $20 right now, but that might be holiday sale prices, I don't know, but it's somewhere in that range. So let's compare the Hini gouache to my Holbein gouache set. I'm going to use this as my benchmark for gouache and how it performs, because that's what I've had the most experience with, and in my opinion, they work really well. So this Holbein set has 12 tubes of paint, each tube holding 5 milliliters of paint. This set costs somewhere between $30 and $40. I don't really remember because I got them a few years ago and I can't find them listed anywhere anymore, which is tragic. I'm very scared. So these tubes are like really, really small. And here's a tube of white acrylic gouache that I bought, which is 20 milliliters, and this costs somewhere around $15. So off the bat, you're getting an insane amount of paint for a comparatively low cost from the Hini set. The Holbein set comes with 60 milliliters of paint total, while the Hini comes with 720 with about a $10 price difference. That's crazy. That's a huge amount of paint. It's crazy. Okay, let's get into the packaging. I am literally in love with this packaging. I love it so much. When I first got the paints, I swear to you, I would just randomly get up from whatever I was doing and I would like pick up the box and just stare at it and feel it and feel its weight, because the packaging is just so pretty. The pink, it's like the perfect shade of pink. It reminds me of Barbie. Like every time I look at it, I think it's like some Barbie set or something. I'm so in love with it. It's also like really hefty. Like I was shocked by the weight when I picked it up for the first time. You know how like heavier things just feel like they are more valuable? It's one of those things. It just feels like it's good quality or expensive or whatever, just because it's kind of heavy for the size. It's also designed really minimalistically, the case is, which I think is very nice looking. Like they have really cute, this little like design. It's overall A+ packaging, love it. So the way Hini gouache works is there's this outside container, right? And then these little packets inside of the jelly gouache. Each color is in its own little container. And there's like a little pocket for the three brushes that come with it. And then the mixing palette sits on top of all of that. I guess the idea, back when these were like all the rage on Instagram, I recall the appeal being that these paints were supposed to last a long time because they're jelly and they're different and the packaging would keep them like fresh, right? That was like half the reason that they were so popular. The case has a lid and it like clasps on both sides, and I personally have a really hard time closing it properly. I don't know if every case has this problem because, you know, the seal is so tight to keep the paint fresh, or maybe I'm not putting the palette in properly and it's making it hard to close, but it took me some practice to figure out how to properly close the lid without it popping back open. And I thought like, okay, it must be a really tight seal to keep the paints fresh. But no. In theory, the inside of the case is really pretty, but functionally, it just doesn't work that well. The paints are fine. They're not ruined. Like the whole thing, it works. It's not ruined, right? But it's just not functional. The package is not airtight, so every time I open my case, I notice that a small amount of each paint packet has hardened and crusted. You'll see a lot of people squirt their packets with water with a spray bottle to reactivate them, like Instagram videos. They're definitely still usable and they reactivate, but it's not ideal, you know what I mean? Like you're always going to be sacrificing a small amount of your paint every time you open the package. I wish the lid itself did like was airtight, or maybe that each packet came with some sort of covering. I guess I could wrap them in saran wrap, but like I'm not, that's too much work. It's also just messy. The packets stay uncovered inside the case, so if you rattle it around even a little, there's a chance that the paints might mix or touch a little, and it is jelly, so they're not runny, but they are, like, they're just exposed, you know what I mean? Again, it's nothing too serious. It's not a deal breaker. They're not hard to use. Like, it's not impossible to use. They're not ruined. It's not even that big of a deal. It's just not as convenient as it could be. And then you're supposed to store, like, the palette on top. But because the paints are just open, every time I open my case, I find wet paint on the palette. I've gotten, like, paint in so many places because of this. My bedspread got covered in paint. Counters get covered in paint. My art desk got covered in paint. So just getting ready to use the paint is an ordeal itself. You have to reactivate the paint. You have to completely clean off your palette so you don't make a mess. And then you have to make sure the palette is completely clean again when you put it away so it doesn't contaminate the other palettes with the wet paint still on it. And this is supposed to be in the Amazon, like, listing. If I remember right, it's listed, like, for travel, like, not for travel purposes, but it's good for traveling, right? I just don't think I'd enjoy using this anywhere but, like, a designated art space because it requires so much maintenance and, like, prep just to use it. So the packaging is beautiful. The idea of it is really cool. It all seems great in theory, but in practice, the packaging just isn't as functional as it could be. Again, not terrible, just not as functional. But it's not so bad that the paints are unusable. They're just minor inconveniences. It's a bit annoying. And, like, I worry every time I open the case that all of my paints are gonna be dried up and unusable. Like, literally, after I got it the first time and made my first piece, I didn't open that set for weeks because I was like, I know when I open it, they're all gonna be dried and crusty, but they weren't, so it's fine. I know I just complained, like, a lot, but I swear, those things really aren't that big of a deal. They're things that you can easily work around. You get used to. It's just annoying, and I feel like people should know about that before you buy it. Like, I know when they sent it to me, I was like, so are they airtight? Like, what's the deal? Do they keep? And I couldn't really find information. So that's the tea, I guess. The color selection, at first, I thought was so ugly. I guess based on how cute the outside was, I was picturing, like, a more aesthetic display on the inside. But the colors just, like, I don't know, they just looked ugly. Like, a lot of weird colors. But once I started using them, I realized that it was actually a really great color selection. You can mix some beautiful colors. Some of them are beautiful straight out of the pot. And there's a really good array of options. I really love the reds that they provide. I feel like I never like reds that are provided. I always have to mix a better red, but I love both of these reds that are in the case. I like the colors. They're very organic. Now let's talk about the quality of the paint itself. Based on the price and comparing the amount of paint versus the price to my Holbein gouache, I was honestly expecting some Walmart level performance, like maybe even dollar store. My hopes were not high. I thought the pretty packaging would be like as good as it got for these paints. Usually cheaper brands, if they put a lot of money into the packaging, that means that, like, products themselves are worse. So I was worried. But imagine my surprise when not only do you get an insane amount of paint for a reasonable price, but it's good paint too. Like, it is gouache paint. It is gouache. It, like, actually works like gouache paint. It's not as intuitive or as easy to use as the Holbein. Obviously, like, there's gonna be some quality difference, but the difference in quality just is not as drastic as I would think. Like, they are good paints. They genuinely work well. They mix well, they go on paper well, they're nice and opaque, they spread evenly. Like, you have to, like, my Holbein, I have to mix a lot of white into colors to make it really opaque, or I have to use a lot of paint. I don't even have that problem with these paints. Like, they work really well. They really, really do. It's been months. Like, I'm still in shock that the quality of paint is as good as it is, considering the price. It's crazy. However, I must warn you of this as well. I always use gouache in my sketchbook to cover pages that have a lot of marker bleed through. The paint sits on top of the paper really well, so I never have to worry about it messing up what's already on the other side or even wrinkling the paper. I can do it in either order. I can do a painting and then do a marker illustration on the back, or I can do a marker drawing and then cover the other side in gouache. And they never interact or mess each other up. It's great. I noticed, however, that when I did my first painting with Hemi gouache, that it isn't exactly the case with these paints. I haven't done much experimenting, so I don't know the extent of the problem, but I put marker on the back of the paper of my painting, expecting it to be fine, and when I flipped back just to check, just in case, I noticed that the bleed through was terrible and it had ruined the painting. I went back later to fix it, and it was fine, but it made me really, really nervous. It really scared me, and I'm kind of hesitant to use it in a sketchbook now, because I don't know, it scares me. But besides that, I haven't had any issues with the paint. I still get a kick out of just holding and staring at the case. The paints have lasted despite exposure to air. But besides that, I haven't had any issues with the paint. I still get a kick out of literally just holding and staring at the case because it's so pretty. The paints have lasted despite exposure to air, although I do have to work around some dry clumps, but it's really not as bad as it could be. The packets do get contaminated with other colors easily, whether it be the palette, rattling, but usually it's just my own laziness when mixing. It's kind of my bad. They're messy and they're sometimes inconvenient, but I find that they're all like small problems that are really worth it when you look at the overall quality and cost. Like, I would rather pay with these small things than pay in paint quality. So yeah, those are my thoughts on the Hemi Jelly Gouache paints. I think they're great quality for the price. Actually, they're just great quality, full stop, and then they also have a great price. And the case is adorable. If you're looking for a good alternative to more expensive gouache, if you're looking to try gouache for the first time, or if you just want a cheaper set of gouache to use for fun so you don't waste your expensive, high-quality gouache, I would definitely recommend these. I think the only reason I would caution you against them is if you don't think you'll use them that often. Like, when I got my Holbein gouache, I used them once and then didn't touch them for like a year. And because Hemi paints are prone to drying out, you definitely need to use them while you can. Although I've had these for some time and there's still plenty of usable paint, but the fear is still there. I hope this video was helpful and hopefully coherent. I feel like every time I write a script for my videos, my mind literally goes blank and I like lose control and like nothing makes sense and I'm just typing like frantically. So hopefully this helped a little bit at all. If you guys have anything else you want me to review, let me know and I'll do my best. I also want to talk about my reference really quick. I tried really hard to find a source for the photo, but I couldn't. But I did link the pin from Pinterest. If anyone knows the source, let me know so I can properly credit. I wanted to change up the reference so I wasn't copying the photo completely, but I just loved the photo so much that I basically copied it. I'm trying really hard not to do that as much anymore. I'm trying to work on being a bit more original and not stealing stuff, but I have a crippling addiction to using references. Special thanks to my gay best friends, Arish K, President Liv, Maxi, Jasmine G, Lainey, Ophelia B, Milky Grace, and Ash. If you also want to be my gay best friend, check out my Patreon info down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe out there. I hope you guys are having a wonderful holiday season. Hanukkah's over, but if you celebrated, I hope you had a wonderful time. If you celebrate Christmas, I hope you're getting excited. Go wash your hands. Go drink some water. Pet your animals. Hug your guardian. Water some plants. Did I say that? I don't care. Go do some art. Have a wonderful day, guys. Bye.